When I came to America, I was talking to my father-in-law how much I love Little Women. He said, why don't you go visit Louisa May Alcott? So I told him, she has passed away a long time ago, and, you know, Little Women is a book. And he said, no, there is a house, Orchard House.
Little Women was written here in Louisa's bedchamber. Not surprisingly, the setting was the house she called home, Orchard House.
Louisa May Alcott's beloved classic is a work of fiction, but the heart of the story is her story. She and her family really lived it. Many people don't even know this house exists, and yet it was witness to so much vital American history.
Orchard House was the epicenter of a great American intellectual tradition.
We're sitting here in the study of Bronson Alcott on the ground floor of Orchard House. It's a place that I always walk into with a tremendous amount of excitement because Thoreau was here, Emerson was here, because Hawthorne was here.
What awaits you when you come to Orchard House is some of the best parts of our history. It's an inspiring place to go.
What surprises me so much about the house is it really is a living house. I've never seen a museum like this that has so much character and life.
You spend enough time in this house and you become aware that it's really a lot more than just nails and boards and plaster and paint. Orchard House has a soul. Orchard House has a soul that seems to touch just about everybody who walks through the door.
When places like Orchard House are preserved, with all the music and the piano and the paintings on the walls, it can seem trivial, but it's not, because remembering what was possible lets us know what is possible.